Hello, my name is Mr. Beardsley. I'm excited to tell you about the AVID program. Before I start, I want to give a shout out to Spencer, who's the man behind the camera making all this happen today. I got some notes right here, so if you see me looking down, it's so I can prepare it. So, AVID program. What is AVID? So we have AVID freshman through senior. It's for students who want to go to college, but it's also for students who want to get scholarships to pay for college. There's a lot of benefits to college, but one of the tough things that we don't talk about a lot is over 50% of students who end up going to college don't complete their bachelor's degree. They end up dropping out. It's for all kinds of reasons, but the AVID program is there to help students get into college, but also get through college. So why take AVID? It's really so you can learn to be a better student, and so that then you can have access to being able to go to college. We get to visit college campuses every single year. We get to participate in team building, so we end up going to a Timbers game or a Blazer game. We get to do ropes adventure courses and cosmic tubing for team building, and that's always the fun part, but really it's to help us learn the skills to be able to thrive in high school, to take tougher courses, and then to get into college and get the scholarships so that we can get there. One of the other benefits about it is that once a week you get help in a tutorial in your most difficult class. So those classes that might be tough, you get to bring those problems into the AVID class, and your tutor and your AVID group are going to help you work through those difficult questions. So once again, our grades can raise up. AVID, in order to be an AVID, you need to meet one of the following criteria. So you don't have to meet all, just one. You need to be a first-generation college-bound student. So if your parents didn't graduate with a bachelor's degree, AVID is for you. If you're on free and reduced lunch, that's the other one. So if you're on free and reduced lunch, then you can be an AVID. If you're a racial minority, you can be it. Or if you have any other barrier to college, like your parents are divorced, you have medical issues, any of those count as being able to be an AVID. But really, what do we want? We want students who are willing to work hard so that they can go to college. So if you fill any of those, come talk to myself or Ms. Bentley. We can give you an application. We want you in the program. A few things: our graduates last year, every single graduate from the AVID program has been accepted to at least one four-year university. And last year, our graduates got over $2 million in grants and scholarships. If either of those sound like something that you might be interested in, we'd love to have you in the program. And then the last class I want to tell you about, and this is only for juniors and seniors, is for an AVID tutor. So juniors and seniors who are, and I'm just going to use this word, who are really strong students, and you know who you are. We need you and the AVID program to help tutor the younger students at the middle school and also the younger students at the high school in their difficult classwork. But I don't want to scare you off. You don't need to be an expert in anything in like chemistry or trig or AP US history. You just have to have good study skills, and you help the students that are struggling in those difficult courses figure out how they can be a little bit successful. The other thing that's nice about being an AVID tutor is you get a letter grade. It's a class you don't really have to prepare for, you just have to show up. It's a way for some of us to give back to the community that has provided us with so much stuff. And it looks amazing on your resume, on your college applications, and on your scholarship applications. So if you have any questions, like I said, see myself, see Ms. Bentley, and I'm gonna give it back to my man Spencer. Thank you.
All right,
are we
ready?
Hey students, just wanna share with you guys a couple of options available as you're forecasting within our health science career technical education program at the high school. So you know, hospitals tend to be usually the largest employers in cities or counties. Hood River Providence Hospital is the leading employer in our neighborhood here. And we worked with the healthcare providers and the hospitals, MCMC, One Community Health, The Next Door, and Providence, among some other private practices, to make these classes for you. So almost all these jobs will result in health insurance, retirement, and a nice way to contribute to the world around you through your work. going to stick to the classes and what we offer, knowing that you guys will come to me with questions if you have them. I also recommend you talk to your classmates who are taking these classes, or talk to your counselors about these classes. There's a lot of people that know about them. The three classes you can start with, and I should have put them on the top, but I made a mistake, so watch this. Future Healthcare Professionals of Oregon. We call it FHPO, Medical Terminology, Intro to Anatomy and Physiology. Those three are the ones available to anybody, sophomore or above. There's a couple of prerequisites. Look in the student planning guide at those. We also have workplace experience classes, two of them. You might call them an internship, but really it's just any workplace experience where you get high school credit and you also get to be in the workplace helping or working with or watching healthcare professionals. We also have a wilderness first aid and survival class, and juniors and seniors are eligible for that as long as they've been through one of these other classes. So let me explain each class briefly. FHPO previews about 20 healthcare careers. The class is offered through Eastern Oregon University. We do two or three different field trips to visit colleges in this class. We do about 10 field trips working with some of our older adult resident homes. We also tend to work with either the cemetery and funeral homes or the veterans fairs, learning about all the different healthcare careers. This past year, we all did our EA projects in the class. We're not sure where that's headed, but there's conversations about it right now. Medical terminology and anatomy physiology are both similar healthcare career classes about the human body. They're both prerequisites for the medical assistant program at CGCC. You can get all the prerequisites done at the high school, including writing 121, and get straight into that program. And in 1 year, you could be making good money right in town. Super high demand for those jobs right now. All three of those classes would be super good for anybody going for medical assistants in 1 year all the way up to medical doctors with 12 years of college. Those are great starting points, give you a huge advantage over your other classmates, especially if you add the internship to it. The last thing is the Wilderness First Aid class. That's really a treat to the community here to get you guys learning about healthcare careers related to emergency medicine and all the outdoor activities we have in this area. Teach you guys how to mountaineer a little bit, backpack, start fires, survive in the woods. You get Wilderness First Aid certified, CPR, super fun class. I'm a little biased, but ask the kids who are taking it. Double blocked, hard to schedule, so you're gonna have to fight to get a spot, and you gotta take one of these to earn your way in. If you have any questions, please stop by. I'm an M1. Your counselors know about it. Your classmates know about it. I'll be in the lunchroom next week, Friday, when you guys are forecasting, with a poster and some of my toys so you can see what we're about and ask me questions. Good luck with picking your classes. It's tough times.
Okay, bonjour à tous. My name is Madame Good, and I'm here with Mr. Duchek, and we're here to talk about what is offered in the World Language Department. So I teach year 1, 2, 3, and 4 French, and we learn French via storytelling and culture. I'm here talking for the Mandarin department, and we offer Mandarin 1, Mandarin 2, and Mandarin 3. Take it away.
Yeah, and next year for Spanish, we're offering mostly the same courses. We'll have Spanish 1, 2, 3, and 4, and then AP Spanish. And then again, there are also the Spanish for Native Speaker courses, so there's levels 1, 2, and 3. And then also in your guidebook or forecasting book, there's a Spanish, or not Spanish sampler, but a language sampler course, which will be taught by Mr. Trujillo if there are enough people interested. And that language sampler course actually covers lots of languages. And
It's Portuguese.
And German. And you kind of take a look at how they're all interconnected. So that's another course that's also for an option, I think, for everyone at different levels.
Yeah, so that's all the offerings in the World Language Department. We have French, Spanish, Mandarin, and then the World Language Sampler, and then the classes for native speakers. Yep. Hope to see you all there.
Hi, I'm Brooke Brown, and I'm here to talk to you about the math pathways. First step is you want to pass your math courses. You need 3 credits to graduate from high school. Once you reach Algebra 2, after that, there's some divergent paths you can take. You can move directly to Advanced Algebra Trig and then Pre-Calc Calc. You can also, after Algebra 2, choose things like Advanced Algebra Trig or AP Statistics. Courses that offer dual credit are AP Statistics, Pre-Calc, and then Calc AB.
All right, so I hope you've had an opportunity to learn about the many elective choices at HRV. There are a few more that we haven't talked about yet. They're in the back of the Academic Planning Guide. Classes like Peer Tutor or Teacher Aid, maybe even like Office Assistant or Community Works. But one class I would like to highlight is a new class called Career and Financial Literacy. When we went out and asked students what kind of class they would like, many students said a personal finance class or one of those classes that teaches us about what to do after high school. So we added a class. The name of the class isn't all that exciting, but the content will be exciting. It will include things like how to pay your bills, how to manage your money, what are these things called, taxes, different things like that to help you as you go into adulthood. And along with that, some career pieces, choosing careers that, you know, will actually be able to help you pay the bills, things that maybe will be in the future that we haven't even thought about so far. So I would like you to take a look at that class, Career and Financial Literacy. Lastly, I'd like to talk a little bit about the next step of forecasting. So the next step is actually doing the forecasting sheets. So those of you who are juniors and freshmen, you'll be getting your forecasting sheets next week in your U.S. History or English class. Sophomores, you'll be getting your forecasting sheets right after spring break. Once you get your forecasting sheets, you will fill them out, we'll put them into your hack for requests for next year, and then you will meet individually with your counselor to go over those. So don't worry that first week that you don't have enough time to see your counselor. We'll be calling you in and we'll go over those choices with you and make sure that you have the right choices and classes that you want to take. So I hope this has been a good week learning about all the electives at HRV, and good luck forecasting.